at this year's European School of Haematology meeting, and we are hearing lots about new advances in targeted therapies, immune therapies, diagnosis, prognosis, and response assessment with minimal residual disease in multiple myeloma. All of these advances have come because we have new classes of agents, the immunomodulatory drugs, the proteasome inhibitors, the monoclonal antibodies, and HDAC inhibitors. All of them to date have been used as combinations either as initial therapy or for therapy for relapsed disease. So in my presentation here, I tried to go into the future and talk about combinations where we can block the ubiquitin proteasome system, not only with proteasome inhibitors, but upstream with ubiquitin receptor inhibitors, combinations to get more complete inhibition of this pathway, or even overcome proteasome inhibitor resistance. I also talked about how the immunomodulatory drugs might be improved. We can utilize them to degrade proteins selectively, the so-called degronimid concept, so that we can not only with the thalidomide, lenalidomide, and pomalidomide degrade what we know, the Ikaros 1 and 3 targets result in myeloma cytotoxicity, but also program them to degrade other essential substrates that myeloma needs to grow and survive. I also talked about many ways that we could potentially overcome resistance to immunomodulatory drugs. Strategies to restore the cereblon levels in patient myeloma cells. Strategies to target other substrates of the immunomodulatory drugs. So suffice it to say, there are going to be future ways to combine strategies and better overcome resistance or sensitize to the immunomodulatory drugs. And then I talked in depth about the immune therapies, the antibodies, the bispecific T-cell engagers, vaccines, CAR T-cells, all of which are very promising in and of themselves, but there is strong rationale to be utilizing them together, and the preliminary data is quite strong. And finally, I talked about the epigenetic and genetic therapies in myeloma. Again, they have been used in combination. So we have clinical trials now coming, the MyDRUG trial, that is based on genomic profiling and will utilize combinations of treatments. And in the epigenetic area, both demethylases and methyltransferases, which are the two classes of agents, are coming to the clinic in myeloma, again in combination. So in summary, we've had great progress to date. We have some new team members, new drugs coming, and new classes of drugs. And the way they'll be used most effectively will be in combinations.